dream shawl with one skein of candy yarn or souffle luxe by Stanley. Color number A12 is this color. It goes from cream to sandy up to dark blue to light blue. I use crochet hook size E 3.5 mm by Clover. I will take it out and I start crocheting from outside of the skein, not the inside, while the color inside is cream and it's harsh to see. Here's the dark color and inside is the light color. So let's see, here's a little wooden heart. If you like to pull from the inside, turn the skein around and here's the heart. If you crochet from the outside, let the thick side below and take the yarn from the outside. Otherwise, just turn it around and you can pull from the inside out. So from this side, you turn the skein around. I'll put this one back here inside of the skein, otherwise it comes out every time. I'll turn it around, pick out the yarn here, first one here. I put it up there and let's get started with crocheting a foundation double crochet row from 331 double crochets. So we start with putting a chain up loop, slip stitch or slip knot actually. Start with 4 chains, 1, 2, 3 and 4. That counts as a double crochet plus chain 1. Now you make one double crochet in the first chain you made. So put your hook underneath 2 loops and pull up the loop. Now you first pull through 1. This loop here counts as your chain. When you make a full chain and then double crochet into the chain, you've got the same as this. And then pull through and pull through. So now you've got 2 double crochets and 2 chains. Yarn around. Turn your work towards you. And here you'll see a V-stitch and you put your hook underneath both loops. So that is actually your chain you usually make. But we do 2 in 1. So you make a chain and a double crochet in one row, in one time. That way you get the maximum stretch of your row in both sides of this crochet item. So underneath 2 loops and pull up that loop. First you make your chain, so pull through 1 and then pull through 2 and pull through 2. That means 3 foundation double crochets. Now the fourth, underneath 2 loops, so underneath a V-stitch here, pick up the yarn and pull through, yarn around and pull through 1, that's your chain, yarn around, pull through 2 and yarn around, pull through 2. That's your first fourth double crochet. Well, one more, yarn around, go back to the first chain you make, go underneath 2 loops, yarn around and pull up the loop, yarn around and make your chain 1, so your foundation chain, and then you make your double crochet. So that's the fifth double crochet, foundation double crochet. Crochet 331 foundation double crochets and this is what it should look like. 331 double crochets. Row 2. We crochet 4 chains. That means 3 chains for the first double crochet and a chain 1 to space, to create a space. Turn around. This 3 here is your first double. That's the chain 1 that counts for the second double. And then you go to the third double and there, so you skip those 2 and you go to the third and then you make 1 double crochet in that one. Then, chain 1, skip 1 stitch and double crochet in the next. Chain 1, skip 1 stitch and double crochet in the next. Chain 1, skip 1 stitch and double crochet to be repeated throughout this row. So chain 1, skip a stitch, and double crochet in the following stitch. Repeat this up until the last stitch of this row, and then we start row number 3. Well, this is my second row is finished. I will start with row 3. Crochet 3 chains for the first double crochet. Turn around. In the chain 1 space and on top of the doubles, you make 1 double crochet. So, yarn around. This chain 3 counts as your first double crochet. So, here's the next space, the chain 1 space, you make 1 double crochet. And on top of the double crochet, you make 1 double crochet. Double crochet in a chain 1 space. And double crochet on top of the double crochet. Keep on continuing up until the last stitch, and then we'll start with row number 4. We'll finish this row together to see how to work in the last stitch. So, one double in a chain 1 space and one double crochet on top of the double crochet. Please do remind I work with US terms only. This is how it looks like. Row 3 is finished. And I'll start on row 4. Here is the third chain. There, make your last double crochet in. Basis of the flower motif. Chain 1 and turn your work around. In the first stitch, here, you make directly your single crochet. Here. Chain 2. Skip 2 stitches and in the third, you make a double crochet, chain 2, double crochet in the same stitch. It's like a V-stitch. It looks like this. Chain 2, 1, 2. Skip the next 2 stitches and in the third stitch you make a single crochet. Now to be repeated, chain 2, skip 2 stitches, in the third you make a double crochet, chain 2 and a double crochet in the same stitch. Now chain 2, 1, 2, skip 2 stitches and single crochet in the third. This to be repeated up until the end of this row. Row 4 is finished and we start off with row 5. Here's the last stitch to be placed in the third chain. 1, 2, 3, 4 chains. That counts as 3 chains for double plus 1 for the spacing. To create the space between the stitches. Turn your work around. Now, start with a flower motif. We go to the V-stitch. In the V-stitch, you crochet 3 double crochet together. So, it's the first unfinished double crochet. In the same stitch, you make a second unfinished double crochet and a third unfinished double crochet. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4 loops on the hook, yarn around and pull through. Chain 1 to secure, plus 1 more is 2 single crochet, 2 chains. Back in the same space, you repeat it again. So, first unfinished double, the second unfinished double, and the third unfinished double. 4 loops on the hook, yarn around and pull through and chain 2. 1 to secure and 1 to space. Move it a bit up and then the third time 3 double crochets together. So it's the first unfinished double crochet, the second unfinished double crochet and the third unfinished double crochet. 4 loops on the hook, yarn around and pull through. Now chain 1 to secure and skip directly to the next V-stitch here and to be repeated. So 3 double crochet together is the first unfinished double crochet, the second unfinished double crochet and the third unfinished double crochet. 4 loops and hook, yarn around and pull through. Chain 1 to secure plus 1 more to space it up. And one more time. First unfinished double, the second unfinished double crochet and the third unfinished double crochet, 4 loops on the hook and pull through. Chain 1 to secure plus 1 to space it. move it up a bit, and then the third time, 3 double crochet together. So this is the first unfinished double crochet, the second unfinished double crochet, and the third unfinished double crochet, 4 loops on the hook and pull through, chain 1 to secure, and then to the next V-stitch, and to be repeated. So 3 unfinished double crochet together, chain 2, 3 unfinished double crochets together, chain 2, 3 unfinished double crochet together, chain 1, and go to the next V-stitch, and to be repeated throughout this row, and we'll meet each other again at the end of this row. We'll finish off together. I already made my chain 1, and now here is the single crochet from this row, previous row. In that single crochet you make a double crochet. Sorry, I'm stuck on the one thread. It looks like this. Now this row has been finished. Now we start with row number 6. Chain 1, 2, 3 for a chain, for the first double, plus 1 to space it up a bit. Turn around. Now skip to the chain 2 spaces and the chain 1 spaces. In those spaces you make a double crochet, and in between them you make a chain. So 3 chains counts as double, plus chain 1 is a single spacing, and then between the 2 clusters you make a double crochet. Chain 1, between the next 2 clusters and make a double crochet. Chain 1, between the 2 flowers you make 1 double crochet. Chain 1, between the 2 clusters here, make 1 double crochet. Chain 1, and between the next 2 clusters, 1 double crochet. Chain 1, and between the 2 flowers, 1 double crochet. Repeat it, and here you make your last double crochet in the third chain. So you skip 1 chain from the flower on, and then in the second chain you make a double. Now we go in with row 3 and a row 2 to be repeated, and then you see me again. So fully double crochet row, and then a double crochet chain 1 row on top of it. Row 9, chain 1, and turn around. On top of the first double crochet you'll make a single crochet. And now in the chain 1, or around, whether you prefer around or in the chain 1, that's up to you. I prefer to crochet in the stitch itself. 1 single crochet. Now we skip 1 chain space and we go to the following chain space here. Now we make 7 treble crochets in the chain 1 or in the chain 1 space. It's up to you what you want. You make 7 treble crochets. So it's the first one. Yarn around twice, go into the same stitch or space, make your second treble crochet, and your third. Oh, sorry. Fourth, fifth, and sixth, and seventh treble crochet. Now it's finished. Now we skip 1 chain space here and go to the following chain space, and you make a single crochet into the space or in chain 1 itself. I already prefer to make the single in the chain 1 itself. Now to be repeated. So we skip 1 chain 1 space and we go to the next chain 1 space, and in the chain 1 space you make 7 treble crochet in 1 stitch. So this is number 1 and number 2. So it doesn't matter if you go around the chain one or in the chain one itself. But if you go in the chain one itself, please make sure that you put your hook underneath two strands of yarn, not under one. Otherwise, it will cause a big gap in that space. So this is number fifth. And the sixth treble crochet. The treble is yarn around two times, go into the stitch, pull around, pull through two, and pull through two. So skip one chain space and go into the next, and that you make a single crochet to be repeated throughout this row. I finish so far and finish off together. We skip one chain space and we go into the following chain space. Now you need to crochet in the chain itself, otherwise you will get a not so sharp edging, and in the second chain you make a single crochet. So four chains for the first treble crochet, turn around to work. Now you go into the second stitch, you make two treble crochets. So yarn around two times, go into the second single crochet from the previous row, pull through two, and pull through two. And one more time in the same stitch, so yarn around twice, go into the same single crochet, pull up loop, yarn through two, and pull through two. So two treble crochet in one stitch. Chain three. Now you go to the fourth treble crochet you made. In the fourth, you'll make a single crochet. Chain three, one, two, three, and go to the next single crochet between the two pinwheels, if you say so, and you make two treble crochet in a single crochet. So that's the first and the second treble crochet. Chain three, go again into the fourth treble crochet from the seven, and make a single crochet. So to be repeated, chain three, two trebles in the single crochet from the previous row. So it's the first and the second treble. Chain three, and again single crochet in the fourth treble crochet, and so on and so on. So again, chain three and two trebles in the single crochet from the previous row. So that's the first and the second. That to be repeated. So chain three, single crochet, chain three, two trebles to be repeated throughout this row, and we'll finish off together. I made my last two trebles in the single crochet, and I've got one single left over from the previous row, and there you make one treble crochet into it. And then this row has been finished. Now, chain three, four as the first treble crochet. Now you go into the second and the third treble crochet, and there in between them you make four treble crochet. That counts as a half pinwheel motif. 7 divided by 2 is 3.5, so 4 will be the half divided part of it, if I say it correctly. That's number 3, and here is number 4. So that's a half pinwheel, half plus 1. Now you go to the single you made and make a single crochet on top of it. Now you go to the following two trebles, and in between you make a full pinwheel, so 7 treble crochet in between the two trebles from the previous row. That's a mouthful. That's the first, the second, the third treble, and the fourth treble crochet, fifth and sixth, seventh, to the next single crochet from the previous row and make a single crochet on top of it. So this to be repeated. So again, between the next two treble crochets from the previous row, you make 7 treble crochets. So that's number one. I'll just speed it up a bit. Sorry if I go too fast, but you can always hit the pause button if you need to. This is number 3. Number 4. 5, 6, and number 7. Yeah. And a single crochet on top of the single crochet of the previous row, to be repeated throughout this row, and we'll finish off this row together. So 7 trebles between the 2 trebles and a single on top of the single. And you end off with 4 trebles in the last 2 trebles from the previous row. So 7 here and 1 on the single crochet. And we'll finish off together. As promised, we'll finish off this row together. So between the 2 last trebles before the single treble, we make 4 treble crochets in between them. Number 2. Hey, new color. Nice. It's number 3. And number 4. That's a half pinwheel. And now in the you find your 4th chain. So that's number 1, 2, 3, 4. Just look for those bumps on the back of the chain. You can find it easily. Easier, let's say it like that. So put your hook underneath 2 loops and pull up the loop, pull through 2, pull through 2, and pull through 2. So that's the last treble you need to make for this row. Now we're here. Turn around. I rather made a chain 1. In the first 2 trebles, on top of it, you make a single crochet. So there's 1 for the edge and 1 in the half pinwheel. So chain 3. Yarn around twice, and in a single crochet from the previous row, you make 2 treble crochets. So it's number 1, yarn around twice, and this is number 2. Chain 3, 1, 2, 3. Search, look for your 4th treble, 1, 2, 3, 4, and a single crochet on top of the 4th treble crochet. Chain 3, repeat. 2 trebles in a single crochet from the previous row. So it's number 1 and number 2, chain 3, and 1 single crochet in the 4th treble, chain 3, and to be repeated. So again, 2 treble crochets on top of the single crochet. That's number 1 and number 2. Chain 3, 1, 2, 3, and a single on top of the 4th treble crochet. To be repeated throughout this row, and we'll finish off this row together. I made the last 2 trebles plus a chain 3. Now we search for the 4th treble. 1, 2, 3, 4, that's here. Make a single on top of it, and then into the 4th chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, it's on the top. Put your hook underneath 2 loops, and then you make your last single crochet of this row. Chain 3, next row. Turn around. Now, not in this one, but in the next single, you make a double crochet. And now, in every chain 3 space, you make 3 doubles, and in between the 2 trebles you make 1 double crochet, and on top of the single crochet you make 1 double crochet. So let's start. 3 double crochets around chain 3. 1, 2, and number 3. Then the 2 trebles you make a double crochet in between them. Chain 3, you make 3 double crochets around them. 1, 2, and number 3. And 1 double crochet on top of the single crochet. So that to be repeated throughout this row. Up until the end of this row, we get together and we finish off this row together and we start the new row together. So, three doubles around chain three, one double in between the two trebles, and three doubles around chain three, and one double in top of the single crochet. Like this. Repeat this and we finish off this row together. Okay, here I am. I already made my last double crochet between the two trebles. I've got one stitch left over. And in the last single crochet, you make one double crochet. So in the corner here. Oh, I don't have it here. I see I crocheted it a bit too tight in the previous row. So, last double crochet. This row is finished. Now, Complaining, hear me. Now, you make one row with a chain, double crochet, chain one spaces. And then the next row, fully double crochet. So, and then from row 4 up until row 15 to be repeated. So, first from here on till here to be repeated one more time. And then you make one more the flower motif. So, a flower pinwheel, flower pinwheel, a flower. And then we go around with a granny stitch. So, from now to row 2 and 3 to be repeated, and then start row 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and then number 14, 15, and so on and so on. So this piece to be repeated, and then one more time the flower motif. Just rewind the tutorial if you don't know anymore to re-see it again. Well, I just finished the complete shawl here. Well, not complete because we need the border to do. I repeat from here to here, and then the flower motif. What's here in the beginning is also at the end, plus one more row with fully double crochet. What we do now is on the short side, and then underneath the bottom, and the other short side, and then on all around the top, we make a granny stitch motif, and then two times more if you can make it. If not, when your yarn is empty, it is empty. So, if you need a written pattern, please hit the info box. There you find the link to the written instructions for this gorgeous shawl. So, now we'll start with crocheting the granny square border. Chain 3. Go back in the same space here and make 2 more doubles in this stitch. So, this number 2. And number 3 makes 3 double crochets, and granny square motif counts 3 granny square motifs. When we go back, we will complete the corner stitch here, so don't worry about this. Now we start with the double crochet 3 in every space evenly. So we skip this row and we go into the chain one space. There you make 3 double crochets around it. So it's number 1, number 2, and number 3. Sorry. You can make a chain one if you need, but I don't know. I don't do it. Go to the next space here, and there you make a chain 3 double crochet in that space again. So there's 3. Now skip this row and go into the next row, and there I make 3 double crochets in it. So space it up evenly and do count how many 3 doubles you make, because you need it on the other side. So space it evenly and try to find really the chain open spaces to make your 3 doubles in it, because it gives you a nice edging and it won't stretch shrink anymore if you do so. If you need a chain one between the 3 doubles, please do so. If not, just do it like me. You have enough stretch you need for the shore. So that's number one. It is on top of the treble, by the way. And then go to the next treble, and around that treble I'll make three double crochets. So one, two, three. And then go here in this chain space. I'll make three double crochets. Two and number three. Here I make three double crochets. So you see, every time when I place the three double crochets, I skip one row that I crocheted already. So skip one, and then here three doubles. So it's really important that you space it up evenly. If you do it too wide, your short side of the shawl will shrink immediately. Number two and number three. Let's go and finish off this row together. On top of the treble, I'll make three doubles. One, two, oh, sorry, and number three. And here around this treble, I make three doubles. One, two, and number three. You see, it does not shrink, it does not stretch. That's what we want. So, let's show you how much I've got left over. It's half from the last color, and this is the full last color. So, you've got seven color changes at the sixth halfway, and the seventh is for the border. So, when you're at the half of the last one of the last color, this is when you're at the border side. I'll need to pull out some yarn because the yarn from the inside comes out as well. So in the next chain one space, you make three double crochets. It's number one, number two, and number three. And here, three doubles. It's number one, number two, and number three. Skip that space and go here in this space here. You make three doubles, and that makes the perfect space because now we make it at the right spot up to the end. So here's the last chain space. Three doubles inside of it, or around it, sorry. And now we're at the corner. I'll explain how to do the corner. It's the first chain you made here. So in the first double from this row, you make three doubles. It's number one, number two, and number three. Now chain two, and in the same space you make three more double crochets. So it's the first double crochet, second double crochet, and the third double crochet. So now you've got a nice little corner here. Now we go around the long side. This is the front post foundation double crochet row you made when you start the shawl. Skip the first two stitches, one, two, and in the third you make three double crochets. Number one, number two, and number three. Skip two stitches, and in the next you make three double crochets. One, it's number two, and number three. To be repeated up until you're at the next corner. I'm at the corner. I've got three stitches left over. So one, two, skip, and in the third of or so the last stitch you make the corner. So three double crochets in that last stitch, one, two, and number three. And this is the corner, so you make a chain two, one, two, and three more double crochets in the same spot. This is number one. I put the yarn here, so I crochet around it directly so you don't need to sew it in later. This is number two and number three. Skip this row and into the chain space here you make the three double crochets into it. Just mirror it up to the first short side you made, that way you know you come out evenly and at the right spot in the corner. So it's number three. So to be repeated, skip one row and in the next space you make three doubles and so on and so on, and you see me back at the corner. Let's do the corner together. Here is from the short side up to the long side. I space it up evenly and here we make the corner. So search for the third chain, 1, 2, 3, here it is. Go underneath two loops and in that space you make three doubles. This is number one, number two and number three. Chain two and three more double crochets in that same space. 1, 2 and 3. It's really important that you search for a third chain and not on top of the double, because then you skipped one stitch and then you won't come out at the end of this row. So here's the next stitch, don't go in there, that is not the first stitch. So here's your chain three and in third you make your corner stitch. Here you make your corner and not there. And this is your third stitch and this is your fourth stitch, and this stitch we continue now. So we skip 1, 2 stitches and in the third, so actually it's the fourth, you make three doubles. So three double crochet, number two and number three, and 1, 2 skip, and in the third three double crochet. To be repeated throughout this row, and you'll see me back at the beginning of this row where we started. So here I am, here's the corner where we started. I've got two doubles between before it, so that's correct. So in the same space you make three more doubles. It's number one and number two, number three. Now, to close off this round and start in the corner itself, normally you make a chain two that counts as a half double. So chain two counts as a half double, and then we finish off this row with a half double. That way you start directly in the middle of the corner, so you don't have to slip stitch up towards the next space. So 1, 2, 3 here, and in that stitch you make your half double. That way you're directly in the middle of the stitch and you can start with your granny stitch corner. 1, 2, 3. And again, you start halfway like the beginning of this row. So three doubles and then skip to the next space like normal granny squares or granny stitch. So you don't make the full corner here. So here you make three doubles. 1, 2. And number three, and you finish off this row when you're completely around with the half double in the corner plus those three doubles. So in between the three doubles you make a three doubles, and in the corner you make a three double crochet, chain two and three double crochet, and so on and so on. When you come back here you make three more doubles in the same space, so between the two three doubles, and make a half double to close it up, and one more round. Then your yarn will be almost completely crocheted away, and then you'll see the shawl here.